The clinker cooler in our plant is the most critical equipment. So this is our bottleneck at the moment. It's old technology, it's a mechanical cooler. Reliability of the cooler is not very well. We had several downtimes during 2017 and 2018.
I arrived here in Bulacan 2017. On my arrival here in Bulacan, we don't have the system before. During that time, until 2018, I think, we have challenges in the cooler.
Problems on reliability and troubleshooting is very, very difficult. Without the data that's actually supporting to do good troubleshooting.
Maybe it's because of the cylinder, maybe it's because of the pump. We don't have concrete area to focus on.
Also, in the system, we actually don't know what is the real condition of our hydraulic units.
Our customer, Holcim, in Bulacan here in the Philippines, asked us to provide a solution how they could monitor their clinker cooler in a better way than it is right now. Since we did upgrading on the clinker cooler already, we were able to offer to the customer holding predictive maintenance system.
Therefore, when we upgraded the system, we totally looked at mechanically upgrade the whole cooler. Together with that, we actually upgraded the PLC system, and we also looked additionally to install Odin, that we can actually capture all the data, that we can actually have a self-learning equipment, that we can actually get to know the health of the equipment, what the equipment is doing.
And with that, Holcim gave us a go-ahead to do this project, to do the engineering with the help of Bosch Rexroth in Singapore and the colleagues in Germany. We were then able to offer the whole system, from installation of the sensors to the commissioning of the whole system, which is now online.
So since we've actually put that in, it's been a journey, a learning journey for us as well. So we actually learned much more of our own equipment that we never used before. We can predict life, we can actually see what's the health of the equipment.
If there is something coming, or what we can see, some change in values, or we see that the pressure is rising in the clogging indicators or something like that, we inform the customer that the filter has to be changed. With that, of course, we safeguard the system even more than it was before. With that, we know already before the filter will be clogged that it will be happening. The customer can start having spare and can change the filter on time. So the system is safeguarded.
With the system that we have right now, so the troubleshooting is much simplified. It will help us in troubleshooting. And not only troubleshooting, but preventing the trouble. Actually, it's the bottom line.
Same also for the hydraulic pumps which are installed. We can see, let's say, for example, the case drainers flow is rising, or the temperature in the pump is rising. With that, we know there is a problem. I can analyze the problem here on my desk, get the parts ready, what I need to do for the service, for the repair of the pump. I go to the customer and I do the repairs there.
With this system, we will know in advance what components or where to put our focus on, ultimately to prevent the issues that we faced in the past.
Which, of course, also is good for me as a service provider, because I know what kind of tools I have to bring. I know what kind of parts I need to bring. And on site, I just do the repair on the pump, take the pump out, repair it, put it back in, and the customer does not have any downtime on the system.
Definitely with this technology going forward, it is the future. We'll roll it, install it to other hydraulic units within our business, that we can actually be more proactive in capturing all the data of the equipment and make better decisions